Hey guys, welcome back to the YouTube channel, and today I'm going to be trying to make a detailed pike swim bait. So yeah, let's get to it. So off camera I already cut out the shape of the pike, there it is. Now I'm going to be drawing on the thickness of the fins that I'm going to carve down to, so yeah, that's what I'm doing. Now that I'm done drawing the fins shapes and size and thickness, I'm going to be carving down to the shape of the body so that the fins are nice and thin. And so yeah. Now I'm going to be drawing on the stencil lines for the top view profile of the pike. That way I can carve down to those lines to get the shape that I want. Now that I'm done drawing those lines in, I'm going to be carving down to the lines to give the lure that top profile. Now I'm going to be drawing in the chamfer lines, which I will be carving down to later after I'm done drawing those in. Those give it that round look. Now that I'm done drawing on those chamfer lines, I'm going to be carving down to them so that the bait in the end will not be square, but it'll have a round look to it. So yeah. Now I'm going to be sanding the bait so that all those corners and edges are going to be nice and smooth and round, so that the bait looks good in the end. So, yeah. Now I'm just going to be carving out a bit more of an outline to the fins so that like they're more noticeable. Now I'm going to be tracing on the gill details so that I can carve those out and it'll look really cool. Now that I'm done tracing all those gill details, I'm going to start scoring all the lines so that I can carve into them after. Now that I'm done scoring all those lines, I'm going to be carving out all the gill details, which will make them really pop. Once I'm done carving out all the gill details, I'm going to start sanding them out so that they look really nice and smooth. So, yeah. Once I finished sanding all the gill details, I decided I might as well just draw on some quick fin details too, so that's what I'm doing here. Now that I'm done drawing on the basic stencil tracings for the fin details, I went ahead and carved those out too. Once I finished carving in those fin details, I realized that the fins on the bottom would get in the way of the hooks, and that wasn't going to work out, so I ended up just carving them all off. Now I'm going to be drilling out the eye sockets so that I can put in some glass eyes later on. So yeah. Now I'm going to be drilling out the lead holes so that I can put weight in this bait, and so that it'll be weighted down so that it could sink. So yeah. Now I'm cutting down some lead rods to length so that I can put them in the holes that I just drilled, so that there's going to be weight in this bait. Once I'm done putting all the lead in the belly of this bait, I'm going to be filing it down so that it's flush with the body of the bait. Now that I've got all those lead rods filed down so that they're flush with the body, I'm going to be putting some 5-minute epoxy over top of them so that they stay in there. Now that I'm done sanding down the epoxy after it's dried, I'm going to be drilling out all the holes so that I can install the hardware for this bait, like the line ties and hook hangers and all that stuff. Now that I'm done drilling out those holes for the hardware, I'm going to be gluing in the line tie and hook hangers, but not the joint connections yet. I'm going to be installing those once I'm done painting the bait and clear coating it. Now that the line ties and hook hangers are in, I'm going to start painting it. I started off with a base coat of white. The next color that I'm going to be using is like a light green color. So yeah. The next color that I'm going to be using is just a darker version of the color that I just sprayed on. That way I get a nice fading effect into the darker colors at the top. This next color is also just another darker version of the last color, but I also added some brown to it to give it that brown, green, dark color that pike have at the top. Now I'm painting on those spots that pike have on them. I'm just using a yellowish white kind of color for those. So yeah. Now I'm going to be painting the fins red color. I hand painted on some black stripes, which I painted over with a thin layer of red to give it that pike fin look. Now I'm going to be spraying a clear coat over the whole, all the pieces. I'm just using a clear spray paint that's waterproof. So yeah, I did a couple layers. And yes, there is already snow here in Canada. We got a couple inches of snow in like mid-October. So yeah, it's crazy. Alright, that's the end of the video. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe to the channel. It would mean a lot. So, bye.